Hi, this is Doug Dubach from Dubach Racing. We're here today, we're going to show you how to do an engine relocating kit where we move the engine forward 2.5 millimeters on YZ450 anywhere from 2010 to 2012. Fairly easy installation, just got to be patient. Takes less than an hour, so let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is take the swing arm off. You don't have to remove the wheel, you just the chain and brake and whatnot. So make sure when you're removing the brake that you take this little clip off the back. A lot of guys like to try and take that bolt out and they end up dragging that clip through their threads, and that's never a good idea. So you want to take your bottom shock bolt out and the back of your pull arms bolt out. So you'll take these two bolts out and that's all you remove. Your bottom shock bolt and then your pull rod. That's the only two things you have to take off the bottom. Take the swing arm pivot out. I like to put something under there to make sure it's not like bottomed out on this roller and puts load on the swing arm pivot. You only have to again take the bottom shock bolt and your pull rod bolt, swing arm bolt, leaving the brake and everything attached. Okay, so we're going to take a square punch and we're going to knock out your stock pivot or stock bushing. These come out pretty easily. Now we're going to take and we're going to loosen your top engine mount bolts. You're going to remove your side front plates. You're going to remove those completely because we give you new ones in the kit. Okay, so when you remove your plate, make sure not to lose the small, thin steel spacer in there. That just helps protect the engine bracket from the engine itself. That steel plate keeps them from wearing on each other. So now I take a tire iron, and I use a tire iron under the engine, because now your engine will be loose. You've already loosened these top brackets, removed the front, pivot, swing arm pivots out, so now I take, because right now your engine is resting on this bottom bolt, so to get it out, I use the tire iron underneath here just to kind of, you can see the engine's completely free to move around now. The only thing that's keeping it in are these upper plates. So the reason you remove the exhaust pipe is because when your engine moves forward, the alignment of the head pipe and the mid pipe is going to be a little bit off. So what we provide is a spacer that's the same thickness of the distance you're moving your engine forward. So you need to remove the exhaust pipe because you're going to put the spacer in to move your head pipe back the distance that your engine went forward. We're using just a slip-on DRD muffler. And the reason that I'm leaving the stock head pipe, mid pipe, is so everybody understands that this can be done with any pipe. It doesn't have to be a DRD, it can be stock or some other. We provide the kit so it'll work with all aftermarket exhaust. Now, I'm ready to install my bushings in the back. So before I put my bushing in, I need to take on the back side where the bushing is going to be closest to the case, and take just about a half a millimeter of material off the back of my case, just so my swing arm pivot will slide through easily. So I go through the actual pivot just with a basic round file. All I'm trying to do is just take some material away, not of the surface that the bushing's gonna go through, but there's a secondary smaller surface back there. So I just need to take just a little bit of material out back there. No more than about 15 seconds of filing back there. You're just gonna clear, because you want your swing arm pivot to pass through there nice and easy, and only just on the back. You don't need to really come up and around. It's only at the rearmost point of this bushing where it goes in. There's marks on the back of the bushing so that you can get it in straight and square. You want the hole to be in the rear and the back side of the engine, because you're moving your engine forward. Just make sure that the thin part is in the back. So line your marks up, the horizontal marks square, and then take your punch through here and just slowly tap it in. Just be patient, it'll go in. Don't strike it hard, because you can damage the face here and make it difficult to get your pivot through, because you've actually bent over some of the metal. So just be very careful, very patient. So you'll have a different sound once it finally bottoms out. So you'll be able to tell when it finally reaches bottom. It's always a good idea to make sure you've got something to clean your swing arm pivot, so you know that it's going through there. Okay, so now I've just started my bushing with the swing arm pivot through, and I've only tapped it in about halfway. Now, just to further ensure that I've got good alignment, I'll take a pair of pliers and I'll just rotate a little bit up and down just to make sure that I've got true alignment. You can kind of see it align itself, and then you can make sure that the pivot is passing through smoothly. With your pivot in there, and we're gonna tap this the rest of the way in. So now I'm going to tap, take a little bit of this weight off under here, and I'm gonna tap my swing arm pivot the rest of the way in. So now I've got my swing arm pivot in, my engine is still able to move up and down. But now I know it's properly located. Now I take my front bolts and plates that are provided, and now I'm going to install my front plates. You could certainly spend, you know, 20 minutes with a file filing these out, the 2.5 millimeters. But this ensures you, we've already done that work for you, these bolt holes are aligned properly, so now you just simply install these and you know that you're in the right place. Make sure that you include these clips. These go on the back side, clips over. This is your engine side, this is your bolt side. So make sure you install this clip when you're putting this back on. So you take your bolt, run this through here, and back through the engine. So as you can see, we've moved the engine forward 2.5 millimeters. So this is the final step. Now that the engine's located through the swing arm pivot, your new front plates, we're going to now oval out that front hole, or the bottom hole, a little bit, in order to get that bolt through. And remember, when you're doing that, you need to make sure you clearance it enough that you're not driving that bolt through. You want it to pass through evenly. because your engine is held by the torque of the bolts, not by any friction of the bolt going through the hole. And remember to lift your engine as well with your tire iron to make sure you're not fighting against it being loose and hanging on the pivot. So this is how your bolt should fit. You should be able to, with a little load on the tire iron, making sure that the engine is lifted and not hanging down, you should be able to slip your bolt in and out freely. I put a little load on my tire iron as I tighten this bottom bolt, just to make sure that everything is still a little bit free, all my engine plates, so I know I'm not kind of hanging on any one individual one. So now we'll go back, we'll tighten all of our bolts all the way through, this top plate, all the way around. Okay, so now when you've got everything tight, now we can pull our swing arm pivot back out, reinstall the swing arm, and put the bike back together. The only thing that I need to add is when you're reinstalling your exhaust, you take, and you put this, leave your gasket on, this goes on, then you just put your pipe and your nuts on and away you go. We did provide some longer studs to make sure that we accommodate any exhaust that maybe have a thicker manifold than what stock is. So just check when you put your exhaust back on with this plate, depending on which one you have, if your nuts aren't grabbing enough, wait, this is about a 5 millimeter longer stud. So this comes in the kit. We won't go through that installation right now since we've got a stock slip on. Engine relocating kit takes your engine and moves it forward 2.5 millimeters, and that's going to put a little more weight on the front end, give you a little more planted feel, a little better front end traction. So it's a very good modification for your YZ450.